Hello friends, welcome to this next video on major theory. In this video, we will prove that if you are given two functions f and g on a Lebesgue-measurable set E, so basically they are Lebesgue-measurable functions and they are finite almost everywhere. Why do we need this finiteness condition? Because we have seen in the last video that when f and g are finite almost everywhere, then the statement that their sum is a Lebesgue-measurable function makes sense. Okay. So this condition is required for that sense. Okay, we'll prove that if f and g are Lebesgue-measurable functions, then their linear combination for any alpha and beta real numbers, you have alpha f plus beta g, a measurable function on E, and further the product of two measurable functions is a measurable function on E. Okay, so because of the last video, we can just assume that we don't have any problem in defining the sum and the product of the functions, okay, because we are given that f and g are finite almost everywhere and null spaces, they don't make much difference. So we can actually assume that f and g are finite on all of E. Okay, we have already explained in the last video why we can assume it, right? Okay, now I am going to prove that this linear combination alpha f plus beta g is measurable on E. For that, if your alpha is 0, first look at this condition. If alpha is 0, then the function alpha f becomes 0 into f, that is a 0 function, and 0 function is a continuous function and every continuous function is a Lebesgue-measurable function. Therefore, when alpha is 0, then alpha f is a Lebesgue-measurable function, so we don't have any problem. Now when alpha is not equal to 0, and then we want to look at the measurability of the function alpha f, you choose any c real number. So by definition, we have to prove that this set is a Lebesgue-measurable set. So you look at this set, this is a set x belongs to E such that alpha f of x is greater than c. Now if alpha is positive, you can take alpha the other side of the inequality without impacting the inequality sign. So you have this set is equal to x belongs to E such that fx is greater than c by alpha if alpha is positive, and this set is x belongs to E such that fx is less than c by alpha if alpha is negative. Now both these sets are Lebesgue-measurable sets because f is Lebesgue-measurable function. So by definition of Lebesgue-measurable function, these two sets are Lebesgue-measurable sets, right? So it means that this is a Lebesgue-measurable set. Okay, now this is a Lebesgue-measurable set. It implies that alpha f is a Lebesgue-measurable function in both the cases, alpha 0 or non-zero. So what we have proved, that we have proved that if f is a Lebesgue-measurable function, then alpha f is a Lebesgue-measurable function. Similarly, when g is a Lebesgue-measurable function, then beta g is also a Lebesgue-measurable function, right? Now we want to prove that alpha f plus beta g is a Lebesgue-measurable function, right? So we actually, if we prove that f g Lebesgue-measurable function implies f plus g Lebesgue-measurable function, then we are done, because we have already proved that f Lebesgue-measurable function implies alpha f Lebesgue-measurable function and g Lebesgue-measurable function implies beta g is a Lebesgue-measurable function. So now if you prove that sum of two Lebesgue-measurable function is a Lebesgue-measurable function, then we are done. Okay, now let us look at how we can prove that sum of two Lebesgue-measurable function is a Lebesgue-measurable function. So you choose any c. So we want to look at this quantity f of x plus g of x less than c. I can write this thing as f of x less than c minus g of x. Now you have two numbers, fx is strictly less than c minus gx. So because rationals are dense in R, so you can find a rational number between these two numbers. So you can find a q such that fx is less than q less than c minus gx. Okay. Now you are looking for that x for which fx is less than q and q is less than c minus gx. So in other way, gx is less than c minus q. So we are looking for that x for which fx is less than q and gx is less than c minus q. So we are looking for this set. All those x in E for which fx is less than q and intersection means and all those x in E for which gx is less than c minus q. And further, we are looking for all such q's because there is not one q inside these two numbers. They are countable number of q's, right? So we want to look for all q's for which this thing is true. So we look for union q in rationals such that intersection of these two sets is there. So we want to look at, so basically this set x belongs to E such that f plus g is less than c is nothing but union of intersection of these two sets, right? Now this set is Lebesgue measurable set. Why? Because G is given to be a Lebesgue measurable function, and similarly this set is a Lebesgue measurable set because F is given to be a Lebesgue measurable set. And further, we know that the intersection of two Lebesgue measurable set is a Lebesgue measurable set. So the intersection is a Lebesgue measurable set. And further, we know that the countable union of Lebesgue measurable set is a Lebesgue measurable set. So this whole set is a Lebesgue measurable set, right? So we get that X belongs to E such that f of x plus g of x is less than c is Lebesgue measurable set. It implies that f plus g is a Lebesgue measurable function, right? So it means that what we have proved that if alpha is Lebesgue measurable function, beta is a Lebesgue measurable function. It implies alpha f is Lebesgue measurable function. It implies beta g is a Lebesgue measurable function. And further, we prove that sum of two Lebesgue measurable function is Lebesgue measurable function. Therefore, alpha f plus beta g is Lebesgue measurable function, right? So we have proved that linear combination of Lebesgue measurable functions is a Lebesgue measurable function. Now let us look at the product. That is quite simple. So you have to note this thing, that product of two functions can be written as half f plus g square minus f square minus g square. You can open this square and you will get this thing, right? Now we know that f is Lebesgue measurable function, g is Lebesgue measurable function, and we have proved that sum of Lebesgue measurable function is Lebesgue measurable function. Now if we prove that square of a Lebesgue measurable function is a Lebesgue measurable function, so it means that if I prove that f square is Lebesgue measurable function, g square is a Lebesgue measurable function, then f plus g square is a Lebesgue measurable function, then because linear combination of Lebesgue measurable function is a Lebesgue measurable function, then we will get that this whole quantity is a Lebesgue measurable function. So the only thing required is that we need to prove that whenever a function is a Lebesgue measurable function, then its square is also a Lebesgue measurable function, right? So how do we prove this? So again, you consider any c. Here you have to consider the cases. C, if t is greater than or equal to 0, then x belongs to e such that f square x is greater than c. What is this? You want to know f square x is greater than c. So this is, it implies that f square x minus root c square is greater than c, 0. It implies that f of x, either f of x is greater than root c or f of x is less than minus root c. So we want to know all, find out all x for which fx is greater than root c union or fx is less than minus root c. Now this set is Lebesgue measurable set because f is given to be a Lebesgue measurable function. Similarly, this set is a Lebesgue measurable set because f is given to be a Lebesgue measurable function. Therefore, and further, we know that the union of two Lebesgue measurable set is a Lebesgue measurable set. So this set is a Lebesgue measurable set. So we get that this set is a Lebesgue measurable set when c is greater than or equal to 0. Now further, when c is less than is equal to 0, okay? So you want to look for all x in E for which f square c is less than c. F square is less than c and c is negative, right? And we know that f square c greater than c, okay? And c is negative. And we know that f square is always greater than any negative number. So this will be whole of the E, because for every x in E, we have f square greater than c. So this is E, which is by definition is Lebesgue measurable set because f is given to be a Lebesgue measurable function. So it means that we have proved that for both c greater than equal to 0 and c less than is equal to 0, less than 0, this set is a Lebesgue measurable set, which implies that f square is a Lebesgue measurable function by definition. Okay, so what we have proved? We have proved that f is a Lebesgue measurable function implies f square is a Lebesgue measurable function, right? So you have this situation. F Lebesgue measurable function implies f square Lebesgue measurable function. Then g Lebesgue measurable function implies g square Lebesgue measurable function. F plus g Lebesgue measurable function implies f plus g is a Lebesgue measurable function by part 1. And then further, we have proved that the square of Lebesgue measurable function is a Lebesgue measurable function. Therefore, f plus g square is a Lebesgue measurable function. And also we know that the linear combination of Lebesgue measurable function is a Lebesgue measurable function. Therefore, f plus g square minus f square minus g square multiplied with half is a Lebesgue measurable function. And this quantity is nothing but fg. Therefore, fg is a Lebesgue measurable function. So in this way, we prove that sum and product of Lebesgue measurable functions is a Lebesgue measurable function. Thank you.